Right, everyone, so we got our last lightning talk before lunch, and then the talks will resume in the afternoon. So we have Thomas Obendörfer talking about Mailvelope. Enjoy.
Yeah, hi, I'm Thomas, so thanks for joining this session on Mailvelope. So we have 15 minutes, so I'll give it just a rough overview over the project. So what is Mailvelope from the big picture? Mailvelope is a browser extension that you can use as a webmail user to encrypt your email. It's based on OpenPGP.js, so the whole crypto is done in JavaScript. And I started the project in 2012, and a first version was released in the Chrome Web Store in August 2012, and Firefox add-on is also there. I will speak about that later. Yeah, of course, it's open source and it's hosted on GitHub. So why do we need this? I mean, if you see that, it's really painful to do PGP encryption in webmail. So you can, of course, do copy and paste and use an external application, but most of the people don't think that is fun, and so yeah, it's not used widely, I think, in combination with webmail. And the problem is now that it's not only some users, but it's a lot. So we have millions of users using webmail, just a number for Gmail. And you could try to make them use a separate native mail client, but like, for example, Thunderbird in combination with EniteMail, or I saw yesterday also the talk from MailPile. So there's really great stuff coming on the client side, but still, if you look at the numbers, you would not convince all people to change their mail client. So this is the gap that Mailvelope wants to fill for webmail users to have an alternative. And yeah, how is this done? So Mailvelope comes pre-configured for major webmail providers. So if you install the extension, this will work out of the box. And as we use the OpenPGP.js library, it's just a one-click installation. But the idea of Mailvelope is it wants to be a generic solution. That means it should work also for other websites. And this is why you don't find any browsers provider-specific coding in the coding of Mailvelope. So if you know FireGPG, that is an add-on that had a similar idea that was discontinued some years ago, as far as I remember. And when you read about that, one of the reasons that the authors say why it's discontinued, it was too the maintenance cost was too high. So If you're really hardwired to a provider, and the provider changes the internal document structure, your solution breaks. So now imagine you have not only one provider, you have multiple. So it's really a maintenance nightmare, and that's why Mailvelope was designed as a generic solution. And I put here this theoretically. Of course, that is part of Mailvelope that must be a bit smarter than the hardwired solution, so it can be optimized, and I think that we can support more websites time after time. So this is definitely a part that needs more optimization. Yeah, of course, it's all about security. So this is the threat model of Mailvelope. We see the sender as a possible attacker. That means, as it's encrypted messages, we can't do server-side filtering on malware, and we have a script to sanitize the HTML before we display that on the browser. And of course, also the webmailer is seen as an enemy, so all the information has to be isolated, and there is the autosave drafts function that webmailers use when you compose your email. So that's something critical. But also the webmailer could actively try to attack your solution. And the third party can be anything like a man in the middle attack, someone attacks your webmail provider, or like if you have a separate tab open, of course you don't want then the website that runs in this tab can access your keys, things like that. And I prepared a demo, and in this demo I will also show some of the security concepts used with Mailvelop. And yeah, I said it works for all websites, so I thought why not just use it here in the presentation. So the presentation is a HTML site, it's hosted now on Mailvelop, and you see here a PGP message. So this could be like a message displayed in a mail provider. And now the first thing you have to do, you add this web page to a whitelist. So the website is analyzed, it's added here. So you see also the default providers that we support. And now this site is scanned for messages. So if you do a reload, and then the message is recognized by Mailvelop and marked as a encrypted message. If you click on this message, you need to unlock your private key. So this is now, this password dialog is an own browser window, so it means that's isolated from the web provider. And another security feature you see here on the right, that this is security token. That's a color and character combination that is defined by the user, is only known by the user. And that means, should there be, here, of course, we are in web provider land, so that means they can do any kind of manipulation. They can catch your click event and launch a separate window if they want to. So that's why we have this token. Whenever you see this token, you know the dialog comes from Mailvelop. So that's a measurement that you can say we cannot prevent all kind of attacks, but we can make it possible for the user to identify the attack. So you enter now your secure password, 123, and it's decrypted then. The message now that you see, this is displayed in a sandboxed iframe. And the iframe is loaded from the extension context. That means the outside page cannot access the content. So that's isolated, that's secure. Here, the same problem applies to the website can do some kind of manipulation, hide this message, display a false message that tricks you into something. So that's why we have again here this token, if you see it. It's a kind of watermark behind the message. So when you see that, you know this area comes from Mailvelop. So it's not so easy to replace this area without recognizing it. And then the encrypt part. So here you have a text area, any kind of text input is supported. We have here a button to launch an editor. Important is now that you do not start here to write your message, because that's the web provider land. You open here the pop-up. And that's your the editor that comes from Mailvelop again. Here you can start to compose your message. And you click on encrypt. You can choose a key, encrypt this message, and you transfer it back to the website. So now it's the website, it's encrypted. You can send it as a mail, for example. Now to show this also in Gmail. So this is Gmail, I open a message, and this user has now sent me a key, so we also identify keys, and if you click in this area, the key gets automatically imported into Mailvelop. And yeah, by the way, this is the options dialog from Mailvelop, so you have here a key view, you can display keys and key details, there's this import view, and you can generate keys. So that's a simple key management functionality. Yeah, that was the demo. So let's go back to full screen. Yeah, so Mailvelop is based on OpenPGP.js, that's a JavaScript library that implements RC4880, and it's completely in JavaScript. It was initially developed by Recurity Labs, and we have now a new modular design since January this year, and that also runs on Node.js, so you can also do use that server side. And I mean, doing crypto in JavaScript is sort of controversial. So, and important is here to distinguish two use cases. So one is that you use it on in web apps. That means you provide the crypto, the JavaScript crypto from the server. Or the other scenario is that you have a packaged app, or like we do, a browser extension. So the first scenario is difficult. So and there the criticism that you found now in the web about JavaScript, this is justified. So if you develop a web app, serve this from a server, and you sell this app as doing end-to-end encryption or a zero-knowledge app, then really something is problematic, so this will not work. But it's a different approach from, or it's difficult if you provide this as a packaged app or a browser extension, and using also technologies like content security policy, which is available for Chrome extensions to prevent cross-site scripting attacks, so then it can be a good combination. Yes, and the keys are stored in the local storage of the browser. Yeah, in this area, of course, you need to do security audits. So the first one for Mailvelop happened beginning of 2013 by QA53. So that was more than a classical pen test. So we really did a redesign also of the app. The security features that I showed you, this was developed at that time. And we're planning to do two more security audits now in the next coming weeks. This will include the Firefox add-on and OpenPGP.js also. And yeah, of course, this security audits, that's not something which you get for free. So the project, as well as these audits, are sponsored from the Open Technology Fund. So thanks also for this support. And one word to the Firefox add-on. The Firefox add-on is not yet released to the Mozilla add-on market. So it is available in the release section on GitHub or on the website, but it's not yet as performant as the Chrome extension. So the reason is JavaScript that runs in a Firefox add-on context is not really optimized. So it's 30 times slower as compared to a script that runs in the website. And that's the reason why so far this is very slow. But with a new version of OpenPGP.js, this problem is fixed. So I have already a prototype that is really fast and that will be released in the next weeks. Once this is done, it will come to the add-on market. So the future. There is signing and verification. That's really a feature most wanted. So actually, signing is already in the development branch, so that can be tested. So that's something that will come in the next time. Then there is key server integration waiting. Attachment is interesting. It's a challenge to do that. But that's also on the plan to work on that. PGP MIME is currently not supported. That means when you get a PGP message that has PGP MIME format, it really looks weird. So that's something we need to fix. There is translation planned and more stuff to come. So if you want to contribute, this would be very welcome. Send a PR or get in touch. Yeah, and I think that's it. And
questions. Okay, yeah. Thank you, Thomas. Questions from the audience? We've got time for one or two questions. There you go.
It seems you haven't solved the search problem, because is that right? Because one of the issues with having all your email encrypted, which unless you have client support you can't really solve, is the fact that you then can't search it.
Yeah, that's search is not solved and is also very difficult to do. So this could be done if you have a certain URL per email that you can say, when you open the email, we are indexing this and keeping the index somewhere encrypted. But that's not the case for all webmail providers, that you have a specific URL per email. So this is also not planned at the moment.
Okay, we have time for another question eventually. Yeah.
Hi, what about SMIME's report, which means basically using certificates instead of PGP keys?
Sorry, I didn't get it.
Instead the question is, you're focusing on using PGP or GPG keys. What about using certificates, meaning SMIME, instead of OpenPGP?
Instead of OpenPGP. I haven't analyzed that, how much effort that would be. I mean, we are quite modular, so we could say we could replace the OpenPGP backend with something that supports SMIME. I'm not aware that this is available in JavaScript, so that would be, some effort to do that. So that's currently not something I'm looking into, but interesting.
Okay, one final question. You raise your hand first.
So thank you for this this talk. I don't trust my Chrome with my password for my encryption key. So is there a plan to support GPG? So you provide the message to my GPG, which is installed on my computer, and then get back the decrypted message.
There was an attempt to provide such a backend. And I think that would be much easier than now really a completely different crypto system. But it's also currently not planned to do that. So for the project, I would like to focus on OpenPGP and bring there more features. But it's something definitely, if somebody wants to work on that, I would definitely support that and merge that also, that you can choose different encryption backends.
Okay, I know you have some more questions for Thomas. He'll be ready to answer them outside the room or here at the front now.
Thank you.
That is all that we had time for. So thank you for coming along. Thank you, Thomas, for your talk.
Yes.
That's for you.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming along. The Lightning Talks will resume at 2 p.m.